hopefully I won't be out of focus yet again. What's up, guys? It's your boy Robbie Petrov here. So, I never know how to open my videos. Ah, thank God someone invented "What's up, guys?" Literally every YouTuber ever. Yeah, I'm being creative once again. I got the idea to talk about things you must or must not ever do while living in a college dorm or university halls or whatever you want to call it. So as you know, I spent probably like 4 to 5 months living in university halls or college dorm. I'm probably gonna call the video college about college dorm because it will get more views and it's more popular. When you just have one room or you share a room with somebody, you have shared kitchen, shared bathroom, shared toilet, all that shit, and you're living in a tight space. Most of the people that live and learn in the UK will know what I'm talking about, but American kids won't really, probably, because I think your dorms are like shared even in the rooms. But in ours in the UK, no, don't get me wrong, I'm not from the UK. When I was there in like our college dorm, university hall, everyone had a room and we all shared a kitchen, a bathroom and a toilet. We had 3 bathrooms and toilets and 1 kitchen, and everyone had their own room. So yeah, I had some experiences there and I learned a lot from living there. I would probably never want to go back there or as a whole just living in that types of circumstances, but you know what I mean. So the first thing you should know, the one way to meet your flatmates, the people you'll be living with for the whole year, is to get drunk with them. Always the best way. I'm not promoting drinking, but in the meantime I am, because that's the best way to meet them, really. I remember I was very cautious about meeting my flatmates, and because I was the first one at our flat, I just didn't know how to proceed with like meeting them and just like go on about it. So the third night, a guy that I met up before I went to England through like some online platforms and Facebook and shit, he's a Norwegian guy, which I still to this day respect and would love to like hang out with again. We met up before coming to England, and he was in a different building to mine, but we were very close. And I just waited for him to come because I felt like we would get along, and that was actually the reality. So he came and I told him about my issue, meeting my flatmates and being cautious about it and being very anxious about it as well. And he was like, let's go together, you know, we're gonna do it. And I was like, I don't know, man, you know. And we started drinking beers, and it was madness back then because it was just starting, like the whole thing, the whole freshers year, you know. And we somehow ended up meeting my flatmates in front of the building. It was very weird, and they were like,
are you the kid that's like never in his room?
I was like, of course I am, I mean, straight up. And to be fair, for the first 2 or 3 days I actually wasn't in my room a lot. They told me that they apparently knocked on my door already to like meet me and shit, and yeah, we talked about stuff, we ended up having a great time. We ended up going back to our flat, to the kitchen, and like drinking some shit. My mate from Norway, he brought some Norwegian vodka and we drank that, and it was good, which was very surprising as I don't like vodka normally, but you know. So yeah, we had a great time, and from this day on, we knew each other, we greeted each other, we talked to each other, it was good. Tip one, I was a long one, sorry. Tip two, don't ever eat from someone else's plate, because literally you have no idea where this shit has been, what has been put over on it, and if it's ever been washed or not. In our kitchen, it was madness, always. There were plates everywhere and like utensils and shit. It was literally so bad and so disgusting at some points, but you know. Third tip would be, if you're sharing a bathroom like I was, never go inside without any, like without flip-flops or sandals, you know, on your feet. Just never do that, because literally this place could be the most disgusting thing and you will ever see, basically. Like, you can see, I'm not gonna say what type of liquid's there, but you can see literally everything. And a lot of hair as well. Oh, the memories, I love it. Another tip for the bathroom, always try to go there after the cleaning lady has been already there and like cleaned this beautiful mess. Tip number 3 or 4, I don't know. If you hear someone is having sex, like above you or below you, that's not a good reference. Just turn off the music and yeah, that's it, try to ignore him. If you're having sex, well, I cannot definitely help you with that, but you know. I was having so much fun in England. Can't wait to go back. And yeah, as a whole, I think that's enough for now. I'm pretty sure I can think of a lot of other shit, but that's good for now. One thing I can tell you, if you have the chance, just have as much fun as you can there, because I didn't do that. My financial situation was pretty bad. It was very bad, actually. And I didn't have the opportunity to like go out a lot and meet a lot of people, but most of the people I met, they were very cool and very friendly. So if you can do that, if you have the opportunity to go out a lot, just do it. Like, still study, of course, that's the main reason you go there. And yeah, pretty much that's gonna be it. Hope you did enjoy that video. I just thought of it and I wanted to make it, because living in university halls is a experience of my life, diversion experience, which I would definitely never forget. And yeah, just try to enjoy it, you know. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed that. Like the video, comment on it, subscribe to my channel, turn on the post notifications, that's vital, literally. Check out my socials, my Twitter, my Instagram, my Facebook page, and yeah. Stay focused, be different, see you next time. Bye bye.